on, everybody. Thanks for joining. It's Dayzie. I went thrifting this weekend. I shared a couple of videos with y'all about styling the console table that is right behind my couch. So with that said, here's some of the footage from my thrifting. I want you to know. Okay, I thought that was a little bit corny, but I figured why not try it. Okay, now here it is. You'll never feel low if you tag along with me. To break it up into categories, so the very first thing that I'm going to start with is home decor. I didn't get a lot of it, but I figured why not start there. The very first thing I'm going to show y'all is this book. It's actually a pretty decent sized book. I paid $1.99 for this book. I thought it was a pretty great price, seeing as it was originally priced at $29.95. And I was gonna buy a book like this at Home Goods for $29.99, and I decided against it because I was like, I'm gonna try the thrift store. And I found it a couple months later, which is pretty cool. It says it has 25 prints ready to be framed, and I looked through this book and I already saw a couple that were really, really lovely, very historic. So you could just pop it out from here and then frame it. I thought that was a pretty good steal for a large size hardback book that has beautiful binding to it. I know that this is not everybody's cup of tea, but that's totally fine, because when you're designing your spaces or decorating your spaces, you're incorporating your personal design, and you gotta remember to keep that in mind. So I got this. I mean, I know that she's not everybody's taste, but she is definitely my flavor, and I got her. I did mention in my other video when I was styling my console table that I like to name my sculptures. I haven't thought of a name yet, but I am open to suggestions because I love her enough to actually name her. So let me know if you got any names in mind in the comments below, because I'm definitely going to name her, or she deserves a name. So I picked her up for $2. And then I found this really cool storage tin. It was $2.99. And I got this one at Goodwill. I think it's really adorable with like the scallop detail on the lid. And overall, I think it's a really decent size. I think I'm gonna put it in my kitchen. It even has this like chalkboard detail label situation going on in the front, so I can label if I want to. or just leave it as is, which I might do. In keeping with the kitchen hardware, I found this little serving pitcher, miniature size little serving pitcher. It's got this really beautiful floral print to it that I absolutely love. And I see myself definitely displaying this in the floating shelves in my kitchen and putting it to use. Definitely had to pick this up. I paid 99 cents for this little pitcher. So the next thing I'm gonna show y'all was definitely an impulse buy. I wasn't expecting to purchase anything like this, but when I saw them, I picked them up and I couldn't put them back down. There are these little canisters. I paid $30 for the set of four. I thought it was really cute. Look at the detail on the roof here. It's so pretty. I mean, the shingles actually look like shingles on here. There's a lot of texture involved here. Then I have the coffee one. It's so cute. So the coffee canister says coffee, and then it says cafe here. So there's a theme going on here. There are these little houses. They're so pretty. And here is the tea. This one says tea on it. And it also says tea shop, which was so, so cute. I love the whole color scheme that's going on here, introducing some pinks, some purples, some blues, and they are all pastel colors. So feminine, which I definitely don't think that I have in my kitchen right now. Little flower canister, which this one says bake shop on it. I mean, how lovely. And I'm looking at the label down here because I did not do that earlier, but it says fine porcelain, Lennox 1990, handcrafted in Taiwan. And this is the Lennox Village canisters. So it's an entire set. This makes me so happy. I have these vintage ones that my mother gave me that are all mushrooms, and which is why I definitely didn't need these. But I have the ones that my mom gave me. They were hers and her mother's before, so my grandmother's. And I have had those displayed on top of my pantry cabinet forever. And I used to use them, but it wasn't until I almost broke one of them. Well, I actually broke one of them. Don't tell my mom. I broke one of them. But it wasn't until then that I decided not to put them to use, and they made really beautiful storage that I didn't need to access on a daily basis, whereas I would definitely access these. I would rather break one of these than to break one of the ones that belong to my grandmother. Perspective, you know? Yeah. So now we're gonna move on to clothes. Accessories first. It is this very unique sort of braided belt. It reminds me of those braided belts that I used to use when I was growing up, when I was a kid, that I think are making their way back into fashion these days. Loved it, and I picked this one up for $2.99, so it was $3. I love the ruffles. I love the vintage look to it, and it also has this black ribbon on it for you to sort of tie around your neck, create some sort of a tie. I paid $5 for this one. It is a Zara Basic Collection shirt made in Morocco. I don't always look at the brands when I'm shopping, unless it is a little bit of a more pricey shirt, then I'll look at the brand to see if it's actually worth purchase. I also got this shirt, very simple, very loose and airy fitting shirt. It's from H&M. It's a size 4. And normally I wear a size 2, but I like my t-shirts to be sort of flowy. I love the print, very simple, but it's still packed with a lot of character. So I picked this one up for just $2. I think this is a Forever 21 shirt in the size small. And for this one, I paid $3.50 for it. All of the clothing I got was marked half off. One thing I loved about the shirt on this one was the shoulders. The sleeves were just absolutely gorgeous. It is just a very simple looking shirt that it's got a zipper in the back. I paid $2 for this. This one is BCBG Maxaria. It's an extra small. All right, moving on to the bottoms. I found this really gorgeous skirt. I paid $250 for this one. It is a Zara, I don't really know how to pronounce that bottom portion, but this is made in Turkey. I really loved the geometric print. It has a little bit of a slip back here. And so this one is going to definitely fit me a little bit longer than my other pencil skirts that I own. So we'll definitely see how this one works out. I found this one for $3.99, so I paid $2 for this one. And I like the color of this one, and I like the style of this one. I don't think I have anything in my closet of this color, but I couldn't put it down. I thought it was a really, really beautiful skirt and style. The material and the fabric is quite lovely as well. BB Dakota in the size small. So we shall see. And I also picked this one up for $2.50. It is another pencil skirt. And in the front, it's got a dual pocket, dual zipper situation going on. And then it just flows right down. And in the back, it's got a zipper and the very classic split down at the bottom. I cannot wait to try this one on. Sunday Rumors is the brand on this one, and it is in the size medium. I paid $2.50 for this one, and I thought it was honestly a pretty good style. So I saved the very best for very last because this is my most exciting purchase. Are you ready? Well, that's it. I hope y'all enjoyed my little haul and try on. So let me know if you like videos like this. I'm totally up for doing more videos like this for y'all. Until next time, like if you like it, subscribe if you want more, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye!